Hi everybody. I just want to say, I know I've been gone. It's been so hot and the summer has been so busy that I haven't had any time to actually sit down and do any YouTube videos. And so I want to apologize, but it's just been a crazy summer. And it is so hot in my craft room that all I can do is go do something else rather than sit in the hot craft room. I have been doing stuff though, and I thought I'd share. I've been into books, like I can't stop making books. So I thought I'd share some of these accordion books I've made and some of the Coptic bound books with you to show you some of the fun I've been having with the journals and books. So first I'm gonna start with these little accordion books that I love. So this one is in a really pretty blue. It's a book cloth that I found that I really love. And when you open it up, it opens up accordion style, and what it has in it are little scriptures. And so this is for one of my friends to keep her spirits high because, you know, she's been having a few challenges in her life, and I thought she might like something special in her mailbox. So this is for a friend at work, and all I did was basically accordion fold a piece of watercolor paper, and I stamped on it a bunch of scriptures. That these are verb stamps. I love using them because they're spiritual. And then this one at the end, though, it's actually Stampin' Up. This is the Trust God stamp set. So I just love the way it looks. It's a simple little gift, and it was a lot of fun to do. I got to use some of my watercolor techniques and some of my favorite scriptures. So that's a surprise for her. I'll be bringing that to work next week for my coworker. Then I made for myself this little book, and this one is one of my favorites, actually. It's not my favorite. You'll see my favorite. I'm going to save it for last, actually. And it's using the Wetland stamp set, Stampin' Up. And some veneer wood that, you know, Stampin' Up used to sell this. I don't know if they still do. But I had some left over, and so I used the veneer wood as my front and my back. And if you open this one, it's celebrating the views. So every place I've ever lived, I've always had a view. And so each section of this book celebrates a view from somewhere that I have lived. And so the pictures are like inside, and you look through the little window at them. And so this book actually can stand completely round, so you're looking at it from above. It can stand in, and you tie it kind of like a star book, but not exactly the same. You tie it and it stands round, and then you can just kind of like a carousel. You can look at all the different pictures. That's kind of fun. You know, I like the idea of peeking through. And I'm going to show you another example of this. My lighting might not be so good in the room for you to really take advantage, but those are all photos in there. And the stamping is just the birds on the beach from the Wetland set. So I really like the way that looks, open and closed. It's kind of cool how it looks. So I have fun with that. I'm not going to post instructions, but I will sell the instructions on my Etsy site for those of you that are interested. This little Copic bound book, so you know, those of you that know me well know that I love Copic bound books. I did this with the Hero Arch stamp, and I kind of stamped on paper that I had completely glimmer misted with some distress stain. And I use the metallics, and so it shimmers. You probably can't tell in the video, but it does shimmer. And then on top of that is the Hero Art stamp. And then when you open it, at the beginning of every, so the back of every signature has been stamped. And I use the watercolor technique to stamp it so that it has some color inside. So I'm enjoying that, you know, lately I've been doing journals with stuff inside. Before I was only doing blank journals, so I'm enjoying finding new ways to put things inside of the books that I make. So this is going to be a little journal that I can use for writing. This is a Copic bound book, really simple. I just kind of did this one night while I was basically watching TV, using a simple Coptic technique. Sorry, I get those mixed up sometimes. Copic is markers. But the Coptic technique is an ancient technique for binding with stitching. And I just used some extra scrap paper that I had laying around and some embossed cardstock to make the inside cover. And then what I did was I did a little bit of stamping, like in gold ink all over the place. And the stamping that's in gold ink is just, you know, miscellaneous quotes and things about, mostly about reading, with some additional stamping of from the Nature's Walk stamp set. So the bee and the birdcage and the eggs. But again, it's just kind of adding a little something inside the journal so that, you know, it's fun to write in. So that was a really fun journal. I enjoyed doing that one. Then I did these little pamphlets. So this is basically just a piece of cardstock on top of some copy paper with three stitches inside, like a pamphlet bind stitch. But what I decided to do to make it more interesting is I die cut into the front of the book and put a little sentiment there that I think applies. And then on the inside, the first page has the die cut. So the front's taking advantage of the negative, and so it has a contrasting color behind it. And then inside on your first page, you can see the actual die cut. This one is using our Stampin' Up! Dies. And I use the word life. And then inside you can see the die, the way it looks when you cut it out of colored cardstock. Same thing here, I just changed the place of the sentiment and the sentiment for this one. Kind of fun. I'm going to sell them on my Etsy shop for, like, you know, very cheap, inexpensive, just to cover the paper. So now I'm going to show you my favorite. So this is my favorite, and I don't know if you realize how much I love orange and red together, but I do. So when you open this one, again, I'm using the embossing to dress up my book cloth a little bit. And then this is similar to the other one, only it doesn't open round, it opens wide. And, you know, if you were to stand it up, it would look like that. But, again, it's using stamping along the bottom. I use the paint daubers to paint orange and yellow and red flowers. But then inside, I have little pictures of, basically these are oil prints that I printed out and put them inside those windows. So the last book you saw, it had photos in the windows. These have actually print out of oil paintings. And so when you peek through the window, you see these really beautiful scenes, park scenes, ocean scenes, and things like that. So I really love it. This one has a scene of a bench with flowers on it. But I really love that book. It's very different, very unique. And so I'm having a lot of fun kind of learning different techniques of how to make books and then modifying the techniques that I find so that they kind of express my personality a little bit. It's been a ball, you know. So if you're interested in learning how, check out my Etsy store. I'll probably have some instructions up like within a week or so. So if you don't see them today, you'll see them very soon. And if I don't get them up there fast enough and you're really interested, just kind of leave a comment below and I'll make sure that I contact you. But yeah, this has been so much fun. I love books. There's nothing to me that's more fun than books. And for me to get involved in books that you don't journal in, but that have content, that's kind of fresh and new to me. So I hope you guys are having a great week, and I'll be back making cards soon. Give me time to let it cool down over here, because I don't have air conditioning. As soon as it cools down, I'll be back in rhythm. You guys have a great summer, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.